Welcome to the video news of the week. Independence Day celebrations took place amid intermittent stormy weather during the past weekend. Events started on the 4th in Colebrook with a parade at 11 a.m.
Look at that. That's what I'm talking about, guys. Everybody's up to
LaPerle celebrated Independence Day on Saturday, July 5th, with the second annual Miranda Sweat Fishing Derby held at the Kids Pond on Main Street in Errol that began at 10:30 a.m., and with a Summer Fun in the Great North Woods themed parade beginning at 1 p.m. Pittsburgh's Independence Day celebration was postponed from Friday, July 4th to Sunday, July 6th. Events kicked off at 11 a.m. at the Murphy Dam that included a flea market, petting zoo, pony rides, a car show, and an antique motor display. At the end of the day, a fireworks display was launched off the top of the dam for everyone to enjoy. Also on Sunday, July 6th, an American Mountain Men reenactment and open barn celebration was taking place at the Poore Farm on Route 145 in Stewartstown. The Mountain Men reenactment allowed visitors to be able to see firsthand what life was like on the frontier and how the guns of the day worked. While on site, visitors were also treated to free birthday cake and lemonade to celebrate Kenneth Poore's 129th birthday.
Come on, take a picture.
The race for U.S. Senate continues as Republicans campaign in the hopes of gaining their party's nomination to go up against incumbent Democrat Senator Jeanne Shaheen in the fall. Last weekend, candidate Scott Brown stopped by the Chronicle's office to talk about the issues.
People are looking for somebody who's an independent thinker and voter, so I plan on taking that openness and that independence to the people of New Hampshire. They have a new ATV trails that they're trying to promote, balancing that the environment with the ability to bring in tourist dollars and obviously enjoy the environment. That balance is the greatest challenge right now. We don't have an energy policy. Senator Shaheen's against the Keystone Pipeline. I'm not. We have to step back and get more oil and assets on the grid and providing a mechanism to export that, to pay down our debt and actually work with our allies to give them more stability so they don't have to rely on Russia and other countries.
Tell me a little bit about the announcement you had this week from Mitt Romney that it's kind of a neat feather in the cap there.
I've known Mitt, obviously. I was one of the first U.S. senators to endorse him for president. To have his endorsement, along with Senator Ayotte, Gene Chandler, Chuck Morris, a whole host of activists, we roll out about 100 every other week. We have representatives in every county. We have city and town chairs. We truly have a true grassroots operation. But I tell you what, it's exhilarating. The energy out there is wonderful. People have been great. I encourage people to get on scottbrown.com if you want to learn more. We have a white paper on education and the high cost of education, one on veterans issues, one on energy. I'd ask people to get involved. They can donate. They can volunteer. We need to take back the Senate to be that check and balance for the president and start focusing on the things that matter.
Also running for the Republican nomination for U.S. Senate is Jim Rubens, who made a swing through the region this past week, visiting with voters and area business people. We caught up with Rubens at First Run Entertainment just before he hit the downtown to meet more potential voters.
Well, 16 stops today. We did three of them in Pittsburgh, and our last stop is over at the NHPR public forum. I think this is our fourth run through the North Country. and it's helped us. We've been here in the winter when the roads were roller coasters. And so we're talking today about jobs. America needs jobs again, the North Country needs jobs again, and we need Washington that's not infested with career politicians that have forgotten about the people they're supposed to be representing. When you're around campaigning and you're actually listening, I try to spend most of my time listening, because when you talk with small business people, they tend to be really connected to the community. Their business depends on the community, and they know stuff. And the more you listen, the more you learn, the better you can be at representing people. And I learned today that you've got this amazing resource in the airport in Milan, near Berlin, and it needs GPS. And if we can figure out a way to get GPS at that airport, we're going to be able to boost high-quality tourism in the North Country here. Jim Rubens for U.S. Senate, jimrubens.com.
Early last Friday morning, Quebec police were led on a chase after a stolen tractor-trailer truck from a lumber yard in Lac-Mégantic. The truck was disabled with spike carpets, and officers were able to close in as the truck was nosed into a nearby ditch. The suspect was apprehended on foot shortly after. The Bury Fire Department and Rouillard Towing were dispatched to the scene to remove the vehicle from the ditch. The case is currently under investigation. The small hamlet of Moose River, Quebec, held a strawberry and ice cream social fundraiser this past Sunday to help with the upkeep of their historic local church. Music kicked off at 2 p.m. and the sounds of local performers could be heard throughout the village.
Gothard Sisters from Seattle, Washington, brought their dynamic show of fiddling, singing, and dancing to the Tillotson Center in Colebrook with a concert last Monday night. The show was the start of the Great Northwoods Committee for the Arts Summer Concert Series, which continues next Tuesday with the Cape Breton supergroup COEG. Details on upcoming GNWCA concerts can be found at www.gnwca.org.
Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday's weather brings partly cloudy skies with a high of 70 and a low of 48. Saturday sees temps rise to a high of 76. And Sunday brings a chance of rain with a high of 70 and a low of 58 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.